today I will be showing you how to desulfate a lead acid battery slash preserve a lead acid battery's service life by use of a common chemical called Epsom salt, found at just about every dollar store for a dollar for about 2 pounds. Now this battery actually wasn't too bad to begin with. It does have a slow discharge where it'll discharge itself over the course of about a week to 2 weeks. But right now we're at about 3.18 ohms resistance across the terminals. And current cranking amps is 931.6. Whereas the battery is actually designed for 1,000 cold cranking amps. So that's just our baseline. Now for your solution, you want to mix about half a cup of Epsom salt with distilled water. Well, it's still a little gritty. You want it just a little bit gritty yet in the water, not completely dissolved. I already have this loosened up here. I also got another battery that I'll be demonstrating that has a dead cell. We're going to try and revive that one. This is very useful to prolong service life of electric car batteries. So what we're going to do is put about 2 to 3 teaspoons worth of the solution into each cell. And unlike what I just did, please try and use a funnel, as I just spilled a good portion of it, so I'm going to add a little bit extra here. There we go. I actually want to do I'm going to start off with two. Really don't want to spill that first one, so just consider that one two, as I did spill most of a spoon. Doing pretty good with the rest of them here. Be very careful when you're doing that. Don't forget there is sulfuric acid inside your lead acid battery. Just a little short on this one. A little bit left off. Remix solution for the next battery. Alright, so let's put that cap back on. Now we're going to mix the battery up. Like I said, this one wasn't too bad. So this is a bad one to test with. But that's what I got at the moment. This was a starting battery from a 1991 Alfa Romeo 164 series Italian executive sports car. Also found in our other videos, we ripped that car apart and converted it to run on 100% electric. Would like to use this battery, but number one, it's about 10 years old already. And number two, it's not a deep cycle, it's just a starting battery. Now, normally you'd put it back on a charger and recharge the battery after doing this process. Let's see if it's showing any difference right now. Enter the cranking amps into our meter here. It's a very nice meter. Doesn't really matter how much the voltage is in the battery, as long as it's enough to turn the meter on. It doesn't do a load test. It actually uses the resistance in order to test the battery. 939.1 and 3.13 ohms resistance, voltage dropped by 0.02 volts. So I think we're going to take this one and put it onto a battery charger right now, and then I'll grab my Interstate Megatron Deep Cycle Marine battery and give that one a try. I am not a fan of those Interstate batteries. So far I found that they're just completely junk. I can never get one to last. Surprisingly, I've had the best luck with Walmart EverStart Max batteries. So, this piece of junk is what we're going to be using in the next video. It's been fully recharged up to what it can. So right now I am going to stop this video. You can see that the rest of this in part two, because I actually have to make a little more solution here. And I'm going to actually put a lot more in this one since I already know this battery is junk. So about that, and then you make into a nice little paste. I'm going to definitely have to add more water for this one, so see you in the next video.